Hey, this is Phil Lilley, Lilley's Landing Resort and Marina on Lake Taneycomo. Jack and I are out here doing one cast today. It is Sunday, the 11th of August. Just right above the resort. Gonna throw a 1/25 ounce olive and black jig, 2 pound line. They're running that 35 megawatts of water for a while today. I got out and fished a little bit. Tried a couple, not new things, but different things. Didn't do any good on that. Ended up throwing a 25th ounce black, no. What was it? Black jig. Up by Short Creek, and I caught 6 or 8. But I wanted to just fish a couple places at least, this being one. There's a little bit of a breeze coming over my back. It's, I think it's out of the west. We got rain headed this way, but it's not gonna be here until after midnight. I think most of it's gonna supposed to fall. Oh, I just missed one. He's still after it. One more time, buddy. I had him hooked, just didn't follow through. And then he hit it again. So that's a miss on the first cast. I took some oxygen readings while I was out before, and it read 9 parts per million, which is awfully good. Water temp was around 60. That's with them not running much water here in the last 48 hours or so. Nice and overcast and cool all day. Fish are midging a little bit. You know, we talk about this almost every, I've got a big old knot in my line. Usually starting about now is these fish really tend to stay in these lines of leaves. They stay underneath those. You'll see them coming up and midging. Almost every time you see them midge, they're going to be in these leaves. So if you're throwing a jig and float or throwing a jig, it's good to throw around these leaves. Tell you what, I'm not sure how I got this loop knot in here, but we're gonna take it out. I'm letting the jig drop almost all the way to the bottom. I don't think I'm hitting the bottom at all. Most of the time. Sometimes I'm not letting it drop very far at all. Maybe 3 or 4 feet. I'm looking for that bite when that jig's dropping. 9 times out of 10, that's when he's gonna hit it. It's right after I jig it. There's a bite. He's still after it. Hit it. Oh, had him. I had him hooked again. Osprey. That's what you heard. He just flew by. Ah. I could see him down there swiping at it, and I hooked him, but I let him go. Jackson, you're restless. Actually, did quite a bit better earlier. Of course, the water was running at that time. It might have helped. It's been last cast, and we're going to go try another spot. Let's go up. Fish here at Short Creek. Fishing right off the edge of the bar here. good-looking double-X boat. Oh, I think it's not a bite. I do like this chop. Do have my fly rods with the jig and float, but I'll stick with this. On fish. Well, these are really good conditions for this. We're throwing a jig. Actually, a jig and float would work really good now too, I think, with this chop. Tell you what, one more cast, and I am going to go to my jig and float. There's one. Ooh. Threw it back at me. I had two or three earlier today that were nice rainbows. 13, 14 inches. And some small ones, but that might have been a bite. That's three times I've let a fish go. Okay. They're biting. I just can't get on them with the jig, so I'm gonna throw one under a float. I got that brown with an orange head. About 4 feet deep, should get it. That was a nice fish that rose behind me. I'm fishing probably 7 or 8 foot deep. Yeah. Back to my old ways of missing. I did not set the hook very good on that one. That one too. So maybe I don't feel so bad about missing them, throwing a jig. Got him. Oh, let that one go. Missed another one. Got him. Yeah, first one was a little bigger than this one. He'd make a good one to eat though. Hold on, Jack. That net is really bothering you, isn't it? Okay, now you can walk around. Come up here if you want. There you go. Just chain spots every minute or so. Seem like they're biting it pretty quick after I set it down. If they're gonna bite it. Kind of quit on me. There's one. A little bit of rainbow. There's some fish that are, trout that are midging around that big group of leaves out there in the middle. mosey out there. That wind is blowing me straight up lake, which is fine. It really keeps me moving, and I can right on the edge of the leaves cover a lot of ground without running the troll motor a lot. I'll back up, let this pontoon, if he doesn't try to go behind me. Ah, not a smart cast. Kind of wish he gave me a little bit more room there, bud. You got a lot of lake over there. Just for reference, I try to go as far away as I can from people if I'm going by them. Give them as much room as I can possibly can. It just makes sense. It doesn't hurt the fishing, I don't think. Those fish are used to having boats go over the top of them all day long. I have noticed that when you get in a situation where the fish are midging a lot, I mean a lot, and a boat goes by, it'll push them down for 3-5 minutes. Yeah, it's pretty good. You doing okay? Oh, really? When'd you have that? Yeah, yeah, she's doing great. Yep. Good to see ya. So, you know, pretty clumsy. About did it again. All right, give it a few more minutes. Got the camera. Turn the sound off for a minute there. Okay. All right. Let's see if I can catch a fish. If I can go home. He tried. He tried again. That time I hooked him for a second. I got to see him. Had him hooked. He had it about 6 head shakes. past this leaf line. There we go. I'm right on the edge of it. Lost my chop. All right, this is getting to the end. I gotta go. Thank you. It's three pretty decent rainbows. As far as eating fish, they'd be great, and they're fun to catch. Oh, I have lost every bit of marabou on that jig. There is no marabou left. There is no way that fish hit that with no marabou. I gotta try it. Bear hook. Orange bear hook. Orange. One try. I'm not going to sit here and belabor this. I'm just assuming that the feathers came off that jig after he hit it. I guess we'll never know. So I'm done. Was that a, that was a bite. That wasn't me. My float moved. And I don't think I moved it. Count. I think I had four or five misses or more. Heck no, I had probably 8 or 9 misses. That was fun. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.